Welcome to H2K Infosys. H2K Infosys is a e-verify business based in Atlanta, Georgia, United States. We provide 100% job-oriented, instructor-led, face-to-face, true live online software training programs. It also includes access to cloud test lab with software tools. We provide live project for you to work on. We also provide assistance with mock interviews, resume preparation and review, and job placement assistance. H2K Infosys is trusted by so many students across the world. H2K Infosys provides world-class services in IT training with real-time project work for corporates and individuals, special IT training for MS students in the United States, software design, development, QA manual and automation, performance testing and maintenance, IT staff augmentation, job placement assistance and tech support.
Yes, test script is nothing but it is for the automation testing. It is not for the manual testing. You can do both manual and automation testing using this quality center. Swati, what is test script? We will discuss it in the QTP. Okay. When we will take up the QTP, we will see what is this test script. Okay. Then, is this clear, this question? Next. But you mentioned it might create a problem with QTP when you change the date. Okay. This is something related to, you know, your expiry date and all. Well, I have sent this question. Okay. Automation with the QTP. Okay, Vinaya, you will not understand it now. Okay. And then I'll start getting another question paper over here. So first let's learn the QTP and then we will see how it is integrated in the quality center. Okay. Okay. Yes, Rani, you can use it. Okay. See, don't get confused. Otherwise, you don't know QTP and if you try to integrate it here in the quality center, you'll not understand that. Okay. Let's do step by step. So, but you mentioned it might create a problem if we change the date. That is true. Okay. So, when QTP is already installed on your computer to run your quality center, if it has expired, you try to change the system date, it can give you the, I mean, it can stop the working of the QTP. Okay, so regarding your QTP expiry and all, I showed you, right? I have already sent an email to Shilpi. Let's find out what solution she gives and we will implement it. Okay. Then, we have to write the test case only for the fields which we have to fill. What is this question? I didn't understand this. Who asked this question? Can you please elaborate on this? We have to write the test case only for the fields which we have to fill. Okay, but I can give you the general scenario. So the test case is to be written for every functionality that we are testing. Okay, every functionality that is present, we are going to create a test case. Okay, is it clear? Then, what type of interview questions related to the quality center will be asked? See, first thing is they are not going to give quality center in your hand and see how you are going to work on it. Whatever questions will be asked, the same thing, the requirement module and then the test lab test case, the same modules will be asked to you. If you want, I can send you some quality center based interview questions which you can go through. Okay. Is this clear, everybody? Okay. Then, one more question here from Shri. Okay, I want you to give the answer. Tell me who is going to answer this. Yes, what is the answer for this? How to switch between projects in the quality center? Let's see, this is a very, very basic question, okay? How do you switch between two projects? Tell me. Okay, somebody answered here. Archana answered. Very good, Archana. Yes. Okay. I will unmute Archana and let her answer this. Okay. Okay. Archana, can you answer it for everybody?
Yes. When we log in, like when we are logging like Alex underscore PC on the down page, when we are selecting default, there will be project 2 and we can select the project from there.
Yes, exactly. See, when you are logging in into your quality center, you enter your username, you enter your password, it will show you what domain you want to log in, what project you want to log in. Choose that. Okay. And then if you log out and again choose the project which you want to go for the next project, you can choose a project. Correct? Okay. Yeah,
I had one question too. I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
Like test cases should be like traced back to the discussed basis, like requirements. So how do we do that?
Okay. So that is nothing but the linking which I will show you. Okay.
Okay, thanks.
Okay. All right now. So all your questions are solved. Once quickly I will revise this and then we will go for some advanced features. See, always don't focus on asking the questions. Focus on getting the answers yourself also. Okay. Because when you go to the projects, okay, you should explore and try to get the answers. All right. Okay. See here. Once you want me, Okay. No problem, Preeti. That's okay. I mean, I was just telling, okay. You can ask any number of questions. I don't feel anything. See here, we have the requirement. Do you see? Okay. I will not create a new requirement, but I will just explain to you in brief. But the condition is nobody should ask the question now till I complete this thing. Okay. All right. After that, again, you can start asking questions. See, what we have to do first thing is go to the requirement module. Do you see there is a requirement button over here? This is how you create a new requirement. Okay. And then you create a new requirement. Beside that, there is another button which is nothing but your child requirement. Okay, but while you are creating a child requirement, make sure you have selected the parent. Select the parent and then click on this child requirement. It will create a child requirement here. Again, you want to create a child for this, select this, click on the child requirement. So this is you, how you create the requirements. Okay. And the various fields here in the requirement are, you have the name of the requirement, you should assign the priority, product, author, modified, reviewed. These are the different options. Okay. Clear everyone? And then. So what do you have here in the requirements? See, in the requirement module, I will list down what else you can do. You can create a new requirement. You can create a child requirement. Okay. You have the different type of view. Currently, this is what? This is a tree view because you can see the parent and child relationship. Another view is there, which is called as grid view, wherein you did the filtering, correct? So this is what you can do in the requirement module. Okay. Now coming to the test plan module. Test plan module is the one wherein you are going to write the test cases. Okay. Let me take you to that. Here is your test plan, right? So first, what should you do? Create a folder, then create a test. Okay. Then the details will appear. You got to enter the details, priority, medium, not reviewed, sorry, reviewed, reviewer. Then the description about that test case, you can mention all that. Go to the design step tab and here you got to mention all the steps, step 1, step 2, step 3. Okay. Then if you want to call the previous test, you can call it here. Okay, let me show you how. Do you see here? Call to test is there. It is just a button. Call to test. For example, I'm recording the, or let's say I'm writing here account summary. Before this, I want to execute the login. Okay. So this is a test case that I'm writing for account summary. I need not repeat the login again because I have already created. I can simply call it here. Call the login and then write the steps for account summary. Do you see here there is call? Can everybody see this button? Okay, so click on this. Okay, the moment you click on this, it will show you the list of test cases. See, I'm repeating again. Click on this. The moment you click on this, it will start showing you the list of test cases that are already present. You uncheck this one. Okay. Then whichever test case you want to attach, you can attach it. Login is there, you want to attach, select it. Click on OK. It will appear. This is it. Only two steps. Click on this button. It will give you the list of test case. Whichever test case you want, you select it. It will get added. Clear? Okay. Test script I explained. This is for automation testing. Attachment, you know. You can attach any screenshot of the functionality, anything. Requirement coverage and link defect. This one I will show when we are linking the requirement and then the defects to the test case. Okay. So I've covered all the tabs. Then I've shown this how to, you know, give the parameter. Then this is over. Okay. This is for generate script again for the automation testing it is. And all the remaining things you know. Okay. Then. Now come to the test lab. In the test lab again, create a folder. Create a test set inside that folder. Then click on the select test. The list of test cases that you have created in the test plan will appear here. Whichever test case you want to execute, add them here. Okay, they will get added. This is your execution grid. Then you have the execution flow. Okay, now I'll add one more over here in the execution grid. Okay. We will check Rani, wait. See here, I'm adding the another one over here. Okay. I should clear the filter. Let me clear filter. So do you see there are two test cases over here? Execution flow means I can set the sequence. Login is there, store locator is there. I want to first login and then store locator. See how I'm going to set the sequence. They are different, okay? Do you see? They are separate. Now I want to set the sequence. Means I want login here and then I want the store locator. Okay, I want to set the sequence like this. How am I going to do that? Very simple. Do you see the login? Sorry, not the login. This one. Store locator. Double click this. Go to the new condition. Okay. See, I'm repeating it again. Store locator. New condition. Test store locator runs only if login is finished or login is passed. Whichever you want, you select it. Store locator runs only if login is finished or passed. Okay. Click on OK. Condition is added. Click on OK. Do you see here? Login has appeared here in between. Sequence is changed. See, I'll show it again. Store locator, double click. New condition. Store locator is going to run only if login is finished. Click on OK button. It will get added. Okay, so you can set the sequence like this. Fine. Then, test set properties. So here you can give the attachments. Details you already know. You can enter the details about the test set. Then we have the on failure tab. What you can do. This is for automated test failure.
So many of our students have given testimonials on how our training programs are. You will find them on kudzu.com and on our website h2kinfosys.com. On our website h2kinfosys.com, you will also find more detailed information on who we are, the courses that we offer, what each course covers. Also, if you're interested in a demo program, please register on our homepage on the left-hand side. Just give us more information about yourself and we will send you a link for a demo class. The demo class is absolutely free. Experience our commitment by just attending an orientation workshop at no cost. Our team of faculty and advisors are here to guide you with the right information. If you still have more questions, please feel free to call us. Call us at 770-777-1269. This is a United States number. If you're calling from the UK, call us at 020-337-17615. You can also email us at training@h2kinfosys.com or h2kinfosys@gmail.com. Thank you for watching our videos. We wish you a great career in information technology.